Hello once again, everybody. I'm Jeff. Welcome to the Glare. This week, we visit the year of 1925. We're really going back in history now, ain't we? 1925 was the sixth year of the National Football League. And there were also 20 teams playing a wide variety amount of games. The Frankfurt Yellow Jackets played 20 games. On the other hand, the Duluth Kellys, yes, I said the Duluth Kellys, played only 3 games. And it's hard to believe, but 1925 was one of the most controversial years in professional football history, especially for one small town in Pennsylvania, Pottsville. Even today, the thought of 1925 raises the hairs on some of the residents' backs. A little more about that later. And amongst those 20 teams, yes, there were some very good teams, and there were some very bad teams. However, the 20 teams in 1925 included the Frankfurt Yellow Jackets, the New York Giants, the Pottsville Maroons, the Chicago Cardinals, the Detroit Panthers, and the Akron Pros, the Rock Island Independents, and the Green Bay Packers, the Providence Steamroller, and the Canton Bulldogs. Yes, the Cleveland Bulldogs. Imagine that. You got two teams in the same league with the same nickname, the Bulldogs. And the Kansas City Cowboys. How about them Cowboys, huh? The Hammond Pros and the Buffalo Bison. The Duluth Kellys and the Rochester Jeffersons. The Milwaukee Badgers, the Columbus Tigers, and the Dayton Triangles. As I mentioned, there were some very bad teams. One, the Duluth Kellys, only played 3 games, lost all 3 of them, and in 3 games, they only managed to score 6 points. The Milwaukee Badgers, on the other hand, only played 6 games, and in their 6 games, they scored only 7 points, and they gave up 191 points in their 6 games played. That's pretty bad. The Dayton Triangles were 0-7. They only scored 3 points and gave up 84 points. The Columbus Tigers, who were 0-9, only played road games, and they were outscored 28-124. I said there were some very good teams. The Chicago Cardinals were 11-2-1, and they outscored their opponents 230-65. The Pottsville Maroons were 10-2, and they outscored their opponents 270-45. But as I did mention, it was a very controversial season. And I said, the team from Pottsville, Pennsylvania, it's very, very controversial. And I said, even to this day, many people in that town still believe that Pottsville won the championship in 1925, professional football. However, in the end, the championship title was given to the Chicago Cardinals. And here's why. On December 6th, 1925, the Pottsville Maroons were 9-2. They went to Chicago to play the Cardinals, who at the time were 9-1-1. The Maroons came out on top 21-7. So after the game was over, the Pottsville Maroons were 10-2, but the Chicago Cardinals were only 9-2-1. So therefore, by percentage points, the Pottsville Maroons had a better winning percentage. However, after the game was over, that's when the problems started arising for the Pottsville Maroons. Pottsville, the following week on December 12th, had scheduled to play a game against some college all-stars. The game was supposed to be played in Shy Park in Philadelphia. Also, the Frankfurt Yellow Jackets had a game scheduled the same day at Frankfurt Stadium. And the Frankfurt Yellow Jackets protested because their territorial rights were being invaded. At the time, the NFL president, Joe Carr, agreed and ordered Pottsville to cancel its game. If they didn't cancel the game, the team would be suspended. However, the Maroons claimed that the NFL office had given them verbal permission to play the game, and they did go on and play the game. And however, they did wind up winning 9-6. Carr, finding out that they played the game, immediately suspended Pottsville. and canceled Pottsville's game. They were supposed to play Providence the following day. They suspended Pottsville and canceled the game. The Cardinals finished the season with two more wins, giving them 11 wins, 2 losses, and 1 tie. However, they didn't necessarily need those games to win the championship because once Pottsville was suspended from the league, Pottsville was no longer allowed any chance of winning the championship. So the Cardinals wound up winning because Pottsville was suspended. If Pottsville had played 2 more games, which they were scheduled to, and they won both those games, Pottsville would have been 12-2. Their winning percentage would have been better than the Chicago Cardinals, who were 11-2-1. Therefore, Pottsville Maroons would have been awarded the NFL championship for the 1925 season. However, since they were suspended, they weren't allowed to get it. And even to this day, you go into Pottsville, Pennsylvania, and there are people out there still wanting to get the 1925 NFL championship back into Pottsville's hands, not of Chicago's. Well, as a little piece of history for you, hopefully next week we'll come back a little bit more into the future. But 1925, as I said, is a very controversial year. Only 6 years of professional football, and there's already controversy surrounding National Football League. Well, that's all the time I have for right now. I'm Jeff. Thanks for watching. And remember, we're going to see you on the clear.